Welcome back to Prissy Beauty. Today I'm here with my June favorites. I don't know about you, but summer for me has definitely begun. And it's very hot here where I live. I've gotten a chance to go to the beach a few times this month, which makes me very excited. Now we're headed to 4th of July weekend, which I plan to stay at home because everywhere you go, it's a nightmare and it's always so packed and why not? So without further ado, I'm just gonna jump into the products I have reserved here to talk to you about today. Not a lot of makeup products. In fact, I think this month was the month I wore the least amount of makeup. In fact, even some days I've done like going to work without makeup at all on my face, which it's kind of scary, but I've done that a few times actually this month. So since I don't really have a lot of makeup products, I just want to talk about a couple that I have today. This palette I've mentioned many times before, and it was my favorite for this month just because it is so natural. This is the Kat Von D Lady Bird palette, and it's an all matte palette. I don't always wear like the darker, but I usually stay with these very neutral colors in the middle here. Nice wash of color to just neutralize your eyelid if you are not looking for a very intense makeup. Just the to-go palette for me, or go-to palette for me as far as eyeshadows and neutral eyeshadows when I'm not really too much into putting a whole face of makeup on. So definitely it for me this month. Another product I have to talk to you about today is a mascara, and I probably never thought I would dish out that much money for a mascara, but it is a great product, and it is the Giorgio Armani Eyes to Kill Mascara in black. Is it black, the shade? Shade 1, I guess there's only one shade. Beautiful mascara, amazing the way it applies. It's not clumpy, it really volumizes your lashes. It is not waterproof, this one, so that's the only downside for me because I really like waterproof mascaras, but other than that, it's a beautiful, very black mascara. Obviously, you know, I went on the splurge side trying to test this mascara out. I've heard always great things about it, but obviously you can find great options in the drugstore as I've always done, so this was just a splurge for me. Then moving on, I have a shampoo and conditioner to talk about. Is the Redken All Soft shampoo and conditioner with argan oil. Beautiful shampoo if your hair is starting to head like drier, like mine is due for a haircut big time, so the ends are sort of dry. This shampoo really, shampoo and conditioner together, really, really make your hair very, very soft without, but it really cleans. Like I have very oily hair, so for me, it really needs to clean my roots. I have to kind of feel that squeaky clean feeling on the roots, but at the same time, I need hydration on the bottom of the hair. So this shampoo and conditioner for me is really working. It's a great product, really, really like it. And you can probably find Redken more like in salons, or like I think Ulta carries them, I think. Anyway, very good product, really like it. Now I've always talked about thermal water in the past. I like the Avène one that I always still have, but I've tried this La Roche, and the thing about it I like about this product so much is the valve thing, like the way it applies. It's just such a smooth mist that this dispenses. I really love the fact it's much better than the one I had before. Love this product, and I love having spring thermal water with me at all times just to kind of freshen up the face, and gives that moisture that you need sometimes, and it's for me, it's great. So I love this kind of product, and this is definitely a great product for me, especially because of the way it dispenses the product. So go figure. Next, I have a tanning lotion, and this is the Hawaiian Tropic Tanning Lotion Sunscreen. I know it's only SPF 4, and I more likely just use this on my legs when I'm on the beach because I want to try to tan my legs because they are so freaking white. But the thing I love about this product is the coconut smell that totally brings me to the beach every time I smell. Obviously, a lot of times I'm already at the beach when I smell this, but it's just a signature fragrance for the summer, and I really love this product. And it's a great product to tan, obviously. I don't recommend such a low SPF, but I normally use this on my legs only, just for a little bit to be under the sun, and then after that I just spray higher SPF sunscreen. But love this product, especially because of the scent. another along the lines of tanning and whatnot. I've tried this Sublime Bronze tinted self-tanning mousse. Mine is a medium natural tan. Really like the way this applies. You have to shake it up well, and then you dispense the product, and it's like this foam, and then you apply on your legs, and then, you know, it works overnight, and it's already tinted, so you can actually see the color kind of already right away. But it, then the bronze builds up as you let the product sit on your legs and whatever you use. I normally use it for my legs just because I'm very self-conscious. I love to wear dresses for work, but then my legs are always so white that I feel like, god damn, you need to get some tan, girl. So I've been using this product and I really like it. I feel like I have not gotten that streaky look or that orange look on my legs at all with this. So I've been using it, I like it, and I recommend. Then I have another facial product, is this Kiehl's Midnight Recovery Concentrate. And it's a serum, and it's basically an oil, and or I should say a concentration of different oils, a replenishing pure essential oils and distilled botanicals to visibly restore the appearance of skin by morning. So this is meant to use as a night product, and I replaced my night cream with this because it's a nice oil. It has like lavender, all kinds of natural oils here, and although I don't have really oily skin, my skin is like combination for the most part, but even then this oil works great, absorbed by the skin very quickly. Your skin wakes up very nice and dewy almost, you know. I really like the effect that this gives. Obviously it's not a miracle, but I have replaced my night cream with this serum, and I don't regret. Really like this stuff. And then last but not least, I bought this little machine recently. And it's this MJoy, mine is the MicroPedi Nano, and I bought the one that is corded because the power is a little better on this. This is basically that thing to file like the bottom of your feet. It is summertime, feet is out, and I don't want my feet to look gross out there. And I normally file my feet in the shower with the pumice stone or whatever. But this I tried and I really like because I think it really does a good job in really removing the dead skin at the bottom of your feet. Good stuff. I bought this off of Amazon. I think it was $30 some. It's not super cheap, but it is. I like the use of this. So I've been liking the effect on my feet, and it feels like it lasts longer than when you just kind of file it in the shower. So I'm really liking this. You know, just one more gadget that a girl needs, you know? So I think those are my favorites for this month. Like I said, I don't really have a lot of makeup products at all. I hope you've enjoyed. If you have any questions about any of these products, please let me know. And as always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!